Today we have with us a special guest here in Mission Control. And this is Alicia Simpson, who is an Expedition 3435 Training Integrator. Welcome to the console, Alicia.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
It's really nice to have you here.
Thank you.
And we're very interested in what an integrator for training does.
Well, the increment integrator is the one that we take all of the pieces of the puzzle and we put it together. The crew is assigned and we have to send them to different parts of the world to train. And so my job is to make sure that I have allocated enough time for them to train in Russia, in the U.S., in Japan, Canada, ESA. And so that's the integrating part of my job.
And that takes place over how long of a period?
It's 2.5 years as a training flow. So I actually get started prior to the 2.5 years, building the training plan, working with the international partners, making sure that we've allotted enough time in each country to get the crew trained and ready to go.
Okay. Well, the travel part of that must be a lot of fun to get that all planned out.
Yes.
So what did you do to prepare this crew for their upcoming launch?
I coordinated a lot of international with the partners with regards to how long are you going to be in Russia, what do you need them to do, what do they need to know as far as Japan is concerned and JAXA experiments and things like that. So I was able to do that, negotiate the time, because you have to go back and forth negotiating, because Soyuz launches don't move if you don't finish the training. So you have to make sure that you have enough time to get the training in, and so that's what I did for this crew.
Okay. Well, are you excited about the upcoming mission?
I am very excited because I have worked with these gentlemen for almost 3 years. We've gone through a lot of things of trying to make sure everything is ready. They're comfortable. They're very excited. And so I'm very, very excited.
And were they good students?
They were very good students.
Okay, good.
Cream of the crop.
And what's the most challenging part of your job?
It is making sure that the crew is comfortable and you've given them all that you think that they need. You know, you get the requirements from the program and you say these are the things you need to train to do, but you also want to make sure that they're comfortable and that if they feel, you know, hey, I think I need a little brush up on this, or I'd like to see this one more time, to make sure that you've allotted for time in the schedule so that they can get those warm fuzzies and just make sure that they're comfortable and ready to go as well.
I imagine that you're really happy when they call down during the mission and say, this is just like the training.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. Very happy.
Well, and what's the favorite part of your job?
Watching them on the launch pad. Because
really?
That means that they're done. They have gone through the training. They're very comfortable. They're always very excited. They're always smiling. And so that makes me feel like, yes, I have done everything that I was supposed to do to make sure that they are in their happy place and they're on the launch pad. Love it.
Great. Well, tell me what you work for a different company. You don't work directly for NASA. Who do you work for?
I work for United Space Alliance as a contractor, and I've been with the company since March of 99, so I'm coming up on 14 years.
Oh, wow. Congratulations.
Thank
on
you.
That.
Thank you.
And how long have you, so you've been working there 14 years. Mm-hmm. Is that your first experience with working with NASA?
Yes. Yes, okay. And I've worked, you know, this is not my first job with NASA, so I've worked shuttle flights as well as station flights, so okay. It's very exciting.
All right. Well, and tell me what got you into the space business. Where are you from? Where did you go to school?
That's a really funny story, because I went to school at the University of Minnesota, and my degree is actually in criminology. So, it's not something I hope to ever use here, but it does help with negotiating skills and tactics and being able to put the puzzle together, because that's what criminologists do. You know, you're always trying to figure out how this happened. And so it actually was very good training to be able to be an integrator and put the pieces together.
Wow, that's something I wouldn't have expected.
Yeah.
And so obviously you've learned how to apply that, and being in Minnesota, you probably know a little bit what the crew's going through out there with those record cold temperatures today.
But yeah, I know exactly what it's like being out there in the cold, and frankly, I don't miss it. But for them, like I said, they're so happy, they're so excited that they probably don't even feel the cold. That's how I would be when I was at a football game. I just tune it out because I was so excited to be there. But yes, it is very, very cold. I can only imagine. I think it's maybe minus 30 in Kazakhstan right now, so I remember those days well.
Right. All right. Well, is there anything else that we haven't talked about that we ought to, Alicia?
No, just, you know, what we do is so unique, and I just really want everyone to know that this experience is so humbling when you're watching them in space and they're doing things that are going to help all of us. And it is just such a wonderful, vibrant place to work that I could not have dreamed being anywhere else. I love it.
Well, thank you so much for being with us today. Alicia Simpson, Training Integrator for Expedition 34 and 35, and we're all pulling for your crew
you.
To have a
thank
smooth
you.
Launch and docking,
yes.
And looking forward to all those activities as they and those smiles on their faces
yes.
when we see them on Wednesday.
They'll be big.
Thanks a bunch.
Thank you.